in the first visit in the first semester, what do? As soon as you come, we take a detailed history regarding your past medical surgical illnesses that you have undergone and any other medication that you are taking, your family history, your personal history, all this will be recorded. Your last menstrual period date will be noted. You will be given a thorough physical examination from head to foot, whether you are anemic, whether there is any edema of the feet, whether your heart and lungs are normal, and your abdomen examination, breast examination. All this will be done. The confirmation of pregnancy is usually by a urine test. The scan, first scan, we usually do around 12 to 14 weeks. But if the woman had irregular periods, we might insist on a scan at the first visit itself. If the woman has urine as positive and if there is no pregnancy seen in the scan, it may be too early a pregnancy or an ectopic pregnancy, in which case we will go for a test, blood test called beta HCG test. During every visit, your weight will be measured, your BP will be checked, your urine albumin sugar will be checked in the later months every visit, and an abdomen examination to assess the size of the uterus, which indirectly reflects the size of the baby and the fluid around the baby, will be assessed. They will see whether it corresponds to your dates, and an internal examination will be done if necessary. Whenever there is bleeding or a white discharge associated with itching, burning or foul smell, or if the fluid is leaking in the later months of pregnancy, an internal examination also will be done. During these visits, please feel free to ask your doctor whatever doubts you have. It is always better to note down the doubts that you have and then clear it. Now, let us see what are the investigations that we do during pregnancy, what are the normal values of it, and why do we do that. The first test is called the hemoglobin. This is to know the amount of blood that the woman has. Okay. Hemoglobin is a substance in the blood. The normal value should be between 12 to 14 grams. During pregnancy, because of the changes that happen during pregnancy, there is a dilution of blood. So it may decrease. If the woman has more than 10 grams, we are happy. If it is much less than 10 grams, the woman will have to take iron tablets, injections, syrup, or any one of these forms. If it is too low, the blood, even blood transfusion may be advised for this woman. The hemoglobin will be again rechecked at around 28 weeks and nearing delivery. The next important test that we do is the blood grouping. Every person should know their blood group when they are pregnant. Even if I wake you up in the middle of the night and ask you, you should be able to say the blood group, because this is something very important. Even if you lose your records, you should be able to tell your blood group orally. In this, we have A, B, AB and O groups. Each group again is divided into Rh negative or Rh positive. If the woman is Rh positive, fine, the husband, he need not undergo any other test. But if the woman is Rh negative, the husband's blood will be tested. If the husband is positive, then the woman will have to undergo another test called Rh antibody titer. to know whether there are any ill effects because of the incompatibility. The child inside can take after the father and can be Rh positive, or it can take after the mother and can be Rh negative. If the child is Rh positive, which we will find out after delivery with the testing of the cord blood. If it is Rh positive, the woman will be given an injection called anti-D injection, which is to protect the baby, next baby, the second baby. Because if the mother is Rh negative and if the baby is Rh positive, during delivery there may be some amount of mixing of the baby's blood with the mother's blood. The Rh positive baby's blood induces certain reactions in the mother's blood, which is called Rh antibodies. These Rh antibodies, once produced, will remain lifelong. So when the woman becomes pregnant second time, and if that baby happens to be Rh positive, these Rh antibodies from the mother's blood will travel through the placenta, go to the baby, and will cause anemia and jaundice for the baby. The baby may be affected severely and may even die. So usually, if the baby is Rh positive and the mother is Rh negative, we give this anti-D injection. This is given even after abortions. The dosage will be different. Then the next most important test that we do is the blood sugar estimation. See, India is the sugar capital of the world. Lots of diabetics are there in India. Like 25 years ago, the number of women who were diabetic were very, very few. Hardly, say, 1 in 1,000 or 1 in 2,000. Now, if 100 women are pregnant, nearly 2 to 3% of the women are diabetic and need insulin. Another 3 to 5% are potential diabetics. So blood sugar estimation is very important. It is again done at the first visit. Blood sugar estimation can be done by various methods. One is called a random blood sugar. This random blood sugar is not of much of a value, because of course if it is very high, then we know that the woman is diabetic. But if it is normal, we cannot take it for granted that the woman is diabetic. Okay. But supposing the woman is in a hurry, we really want to check her sugar and then see if she is a diabetic, we do this random sugar. The other means of testing is called, one is called GCT, glucose challenge test. In this glucose challenge test, what we do, we give 50 grams of glucose. It is irrelevant whether the woman has had food or not, and then check the blood sugar after 1 hour. If this blood sugar value is more than 140 milligrams, the woman is subjected to another test called GTT, that is glucose tolerance test. In this glucose tolerance test, after starvation of 10 to 12 hours, a fasting sugar is taken, blood sugar, and then the woman is given 75 or 100 grams of glucose, and the blood sugar is measured at the end of 1 hour, 2 hour and 3 hours. Any two of these values are high than the reference value, the woman is called a diabetic, a gestational diabetic. Okay. You should know what is this gestational diabetic and regular diabetic. See, some women may be diabetic even before they become pregnant, and they are called diabetic women becoming pregnant. Some women may not have diabetes before pregnancy, may develop for the first time during pregnancy. These women are called women with gestational diabetes. The diabetes, once it is diagnosed, then later monitoring are done by fasting and postprandial sugar. Fasting sugar, again, as I said before, it is taken after 10 to 12 hours of starvation, and postprandial is 2 hours after eating food. That is called postprandial sugar. Then the other tests that we do are tests to find out if the woman is suffering from sexually transmitted diseases. This is done by one test called VDRL. This is a non-specific test. If it is positive, then we go for higher tests. The other tests are hepatitis B carrier test. Hepatitis B, it is B type of jaundice. Some women may not have jaundice or may not have suffered from jaundice, but they have the hepatitis B disease producing viruses in their blood. These women will have hepatitis B positive. That is, the test is called HBsAg. This HBsAg can be, hepatitis B can be transmitted either by sexual intercourse or by needles, pricks, etc. If the woman is found to be positive, then we check the husband. If the husband is also positive, maybe he was the person who transmitted the disease to her. If the husband is negative, then we give an injection to the husband to protect him from the transmission of hepatitis B virus. Again, women who are hepatitis B positive, we don't try to treat them with any medications. Of course, we do other tests to find out how much is the virus load in the blood, etc. But no specific medications are available for this carrier state. The babies born to these mothers will be given an injection to protect them from hepatitis B virus. Then the other test is called the HIV. This HIV testing is done as a routine for all the pregnant women as per the guidelines of the government and the obstetric societies. Then the urine examination. Urine, albumin, sugar and culture sensitivity, these are the three tests that we do. Albumin is a protein which is found in the urine. Normally, there should be no protein or only traces of it should be present. If it is more than 2+, then the woman may be having some renal problem, kidney problem, then she has to be investigated further. And again, we test the urine sugar also. It's a simpler way of knowing whether the woman is having a diabetes. But this again is a very unreliable test. If the urine sugar is positive and the woman has a normal blood sugar, we don't have to worry. If the urine sugar is negative, then she will definitely have no diabetes. Urine culture and sensitivity is a test done to find out if the woman has infection in the urine. If urinary infection is present, it can cause a lot of problems. So if it is present, it has to be treated with appropriate antibiotics, and the urine culture sensitivity has to be repeated to know whether it is cleared. Then there are some special tests done during pregnancy if needed. One is the Rh antibody titer, I told you earlier, in case of women who are Rh negative. And if the woman has any bleeding diathesis, coagulation profile test will be done, whether to know the woman has the possibility of bleeding more during delivery. Then thyroid function test, again, it is very common. Thyroid dysfunction is very common in our country. That again will be tested if needed. If the woman develops pregnancy induced hypertension later in pregnancy, that is increase in BP during later pregnancy, these women will be asked to undergo certain other tests, kidney function test, liver function test, ophthalmic examination and all those things. Some of the tests, even if they are normal at the first visit, will be repeated again after 28 weeks. For example, hemoglobin, blood sugar. If the blood sugar had been high, blood sugar test may be done even every week or even every day for women who are severely diabetic.